I'm Deborah, and I'm here to tell you a story about using AWS Lambdas. I've been using Lambda as my primary mode of compute for several years now, which is unusual for most people. And I, probably because I like it. What I like, it's simple, you write a few lines of code and you got something up and running, and the integration with other AWS services. I do cloud DevOps, so I practically live in AWS most of the time. And yeah, it's great. So here's one problem that we were faced with. We have a bunch of cloud agnostic apps. They could be running in AWS or elsewhere, but they need to access AWS services, which means they need credentials for those. And the thing about credentials is there's some compliance requirements around them and some reasonable reasons that they expire after 90 days. I don't know if you've ever had an experience like this, but it's pretty much a time bomb because some people aren't going to rotate and update with new credentials, and bad things are going to happen. So we need to solve for this. We need to find an automation for these apps, and of course, we're looking at Lambda to do that. So we came up, we added a pretty much a cron, a CloudWatch schedule expression that will kick off our Lambda every day. And it'll just call out to IAM, see if there are any credentials that are about to expire, push them out to the apps. But there's these other people that were onboarding using this process also, and they don't have credentials at all for a day. They're just dying there waiting. We'd really like to see something event-driven. AWS is already creating events for these users that are being created. So why don't we take advantage of that and use that as a trigger for our Lambda? It doesn't work with expiring, but yeah. Maybe I'm overthinking this. We could have two Lambdas. We could do both. We can have one thing that handles the expiration and another one that just handles onboarding. Keep them nice and separate. So here's our two Lambdas here. One we'll call Lambda A. It's triggered by the user creation events that'll onboard new apps and their user service accounts into the system. And the other one, so here's Lambda A. It's up and running, it's event driven, so the developers aren't this happy, but they're not complaining anymore about waiting for their secrets to be available. And on the other hand, we have Lambda B, it's still running on the cron, and it's updating their secrets before they expire. That part's all good. Okay, but wait, there's someone still complaining. It turns out that there was this other event that should have resulted in onboarding, but instead of those events are just going into a black hole. We're ignoring them because, and so we've got to update our first Lambda to handle the new type of event, rebuild the event, replay it to get that into our system. Going forward, it should work, but what if I'm still missing something? You know what? We're going to change the architecture, not deal with that. So Lambda A will handle all the onboarding, and our cron, it'll just check for anything that looks wrong, and rather than actually acting on it, it'll just send it to Lambda A, which pretty much re-onboards it. It takes care of everything. So we've actually used three triggers in the system so far. The cron, the CloudWatch events, and manually invoking the Lambda from another Lambda. And there's all kinds of other triggers you could use. This one's really interesting. Someone came up with this using DynamoDB TTL. So their items in DynamoDB were expiring, and they used those events as a mechanism. I bet someone has done this with S3 object lifecycles also, although it's a bit would be a bit less precise. And there's step functions. It's the native AWS way to do that, where you can build out a whole system around multiple Lambdas. But I said I like things simple, so I'll stick with the cron as far as the scheduling goes. Always choose the simplest option, unless you're just in it for the new tech. Thank you all for listening to my quick story. You can find me on Slack. I'm DHawk on HangOps or the Open Guide to AWS. Thank you.